Croeso I Bysgota Cymru. Welcome to Fishing in Wales.
Well, just look at this absolutely incredible scenery around me. I'm in mid Wales, just outside a place called Llyn Clywedog. And yes, I did pronounce that correctly. And this is Llyn Clywedog. What a stunning venue. It offers some of the best trout fishing in the whole of the United Kingdom. And I'm here today to sample it. Now, I've never done this before, so it's going to be a really, really interesting exercise. Can a hardcore carp angler catch a decent trout? Right, well, joining me on my adventure today is a man that knows a thing or two about this place and this style of fishing as well. Russ, it's a pleasure to meet you and thank you ever so much for having me up here. Just tell me a little bit about Clywedog.
Well, Clywedog's a fantastic place, as you can see. It's 615-acre reservoir and we've stocked, well, we stocked through the year about 38,000 fish and we cater for all kinds of anglers, from novices to experts. Good. I think what we'll do to start, before we get out on the boat, I think if you go with Gaz, our head ranger. Gaz will give you a few tips and a few pointers, sharpen you up before we get out on the boat. But if you have 10 minutes with Gaz there,
fantastic.
Just sharpen you up and we should be ready for it off then.
Happy days, right, game on. Come on, Gaz, let's have a crack. Gaz is the man. He's a seriously good angler. He's got all the gadgets and he knows what to do with them.
Right, Rob, how much have we done?
Not a lot.
Let's have a little flick first and we'll see. Put your glasses on for me.
Right. So,
time in. Yeah, wind's behind us now at the moment. You need to concentrate a little bit more on your back cast.
Okay.
Punch it back into the wind a little bit more.
So, elbow in.
Elbow in.
Just a little recap.
More of in, yeah.
Letting it go higher.
With the wind behind you, let it go higher. So you're punching it back more into the wind.
Yeah, that's it.
Punching it into the wind in front of you, you'd been hitting it nail a little bit lower.
Yeah.
It's like hitting a nail with a hammer.
Okie dokie. So,
right, so
will it get away with
that? To twist your body. You get away, you'll catch fish all day.
Right.
It's not all about casting to the horizon.
Yep.
It's about presentation, especially going to go out and do a bit of dry fly fishing.
Okay.
It's about the presentation rather than the casting all the way out.
Quality carp lesson for you next.
No, it's all right.
So this is it, we're in position.
Yep, what we're gonna do, Rob, you've heard of the humongous?
Yep.
This is the go-to fly when you need to catch a fish. Okay, lots of movement, a little bit of flash.
Fantastic.
So we're gonna give this a little go, see if we can get a fish.
I am actually chomping at the bit now, I've gotta say. So, talk me through this, because again, this is, believe it or not, this is actually the first ever time I've done this. So how fast are we stripping? Do we
you're
go
doing,
on
You're doing it about right. Nice. There's a nice little pause in between pulls, and that allows the lure itself to, and it does this sort of meandering motion in the water, up and down, and that tail flexes, and you'll often find that they'll take it on the drop in between retrieves.
So we're just letting it drop down a little bit.
Yeah, and then that nice slow pause of a retrieve. And you never know, there might be one or two big ones about here often.
There's... Mate, I'll be happy with anything at all. Don't be giving me a big one first.
There's some big fish lurk around these areas.
I notice you're hanging just at the end there. Is it worth it? Yeah. Are they like pike as well? They'll follow to the boat?
Yeah, often they will follow. And just as they think they're going to lose it, that's when they'll grab hold of it. Yeah. I just cast it out and I've just allowed it to drop a little bit in the water. Get it down a couple of feet. That's often the sort of the area they want, and then that slow, jerky movement. Nothing too fast. A lot of people can fish too fast with the trout flies. And I just like a little bit slower and a little bit more movement, and that'll often bring in a take. And so let's hope it'll work for us.
It's a strange wind here, isn't it? Because when we arrived, it was blowing that way.
Yeah.
Oh, that was a bite then.
Yeah.
Oh, that's me not paying attention. I almost took the rod out of my hand.
Just be careful, because they'll often follow.
Will they?
Even after you've had a bump, they'll keep coming around.
Oh, yes.
You're in. Oh, that's superb.
Come on, that's going.
Excellent.
Oh, hello. Oh, there's no mistake in the bite, is there? Blimey. Right. Now
okay,
we're game
just,
on.
Just keep tight line, keep him steady, don't give him any slack. And just, that's it, just keep your rod bent and nice and high. That's a shock absorber, that's brilliant. Well, we're straight in.
I tell you what, they scrap. There he is. They do scrap, he's going around the front of the boat. We might be lucky and he's going that way around.
Just hold on. If he comes in a bit, we've got a drogue out. I'll probably pull the drogue in so we don't get tangled in the drogue.
He'll be right. He's here now, he's just on the leader.
Behind us.
He's on the leader.
Yeah. He's not ready yet.
Oh, that is mega. They don't have scrap. I've had a few trout before, and I've got to say that a lot of the time I find them boring is too much of a word, but this is a different gravy. Oh, go on. No, not quite. Quite nearly there. Oh, God, this clear water is beautiful as well. You can see them for...
Yeah, and the temperature's really good, so they're fighting good, really well.
8-10 foot
there
down.
There you go.
Come on, mate. Yes! Got him.
Excellent.
That's mega.
It's a cracking rainbow.
Right. There we go. Let's have a little look at him. We'll show him the camera from there. I don't know if you can see that from here, guys, but obviously that is, I'm going to say how easy it is, but how easy it is with expert tuition. That is absolutely brilliant.
It's all about the guiding.
Right, popping back in there.
Super, that one's back in.
So that's one of the great things about this place as well, because a lot of venues, you can't put them back in again. And, you know, as an angler, I have no problem whatsoever. If you're taking for the table, fine. Personally, I love to fish, catch and release, and it's lovely that we can do that.
Oh, they go back so well in this water temperature. Super.
Well, I suppose if you know, there's discussions about that to be had as well. How should you play them? Just get them in as quickly as possible and release them.
I think so. I think a long, prolonged fight obviously just wears them down. But if you can get them in as quickly as you can and get them back in the water, jobs are good.
I've got a right smile on my face. Really enjoy that. That's brilliant. Right, next, let's have another one.
Discover fishing in Wales.
You often find that, coarse anglers make good trout anglers because they understand what's going on under the water, and that's half the job with trout fishing is trying to think what the trout are doing.
Yeah.
And if you can do that, you know you're halfway to catch
like
them.
That.
Look at that!
Like that, get on it. I'm trying to say that I'm trying to work out where they are. I reckon they're about 6 foot below the surface. He's not as big, this one.
Got one right behind him. Can you see there's two there?
Yeah.
There was one, one coming around right behind him.
Cool, get in there. It's a completely different skill set.
This is getting embarrassing now. You've had two fish and I haven't had one.
Well, you know, beginner's luck, and it was you that's rigged me up, so I'm not going to claim any expertise at all. I'm probably getting them because I'm not doing it right.
No, you're doing good. Just don't take any more nylon. Yeah. Keep a fly line near the end of the rod.
It's lovely playing them on these. I'm going to say, thank you very much, fish. I'm going to say light rods.
Yeah.
For me, they are light rods. I dare say for you, for trout anglers, they're quite firm rods. What is it? A 7?
It's a 7 weight. Yeah, and that's ideal for trout, reservoir trout anyway. 7 weight because you can handle a sinking line with that and a floating line. Another good rainbow.
Come on then.
Whoa. Yeah. Setup we got today, Rob. We've got a 10-foot 7-weight rod. And that's pretty much a standard for UK reservoir fishing. Probably the best-selling rod in the UK as weight-wise is a 7-weight. It'll allow you to use a sinking line or a floating line. Very, very flexible. It'll do most disciplines. So that's what we got today. I've got a 10-foot 7-weight and I've got a sort of a medium to fast sinker on. I've got a 10-foot leader, a leader of 10-pound fluorocarbon. And humongous on the business end, proving quite successful this morning.
Oh, it's only a little one, that. Can you manage? There's only a nip of that one.
It's not always the same, isn't it?
Good angling.
It's not always the size that matters. It's got a big tail.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. And back he goes.
This is what it's all about, Rob. It's fun, having fun, out with mates, catching fish. There's nothing better.
I'm actually on my third tangle, my second fish and my third tangle.
It's part of fly fishing tangles, I'm afraid.
Do you know what one of the things I really like about this in comparison with bank fishing? There's no trees.
No, no. You often find that, they're sort of novices, they can have a day, and we cater for all at Clywedog, that's the thing. We try and give everyone a fair crack at the whip. We put plenty of fish in. Novices catch a few fish, they come back, and that's what it's about. So this is the fly that we're using. Having a little bit of success on it this morning. It's a black humongous, devastating fly, catches trout all over the world. Doesn't matter if it's on a reservoir, on a small water, or a river. It's worked all over the world. It's got a black marabou tail with a little bit of tinsel running through it, gold body with a hackle, and nice bead chain eyes, and that gives it lots of motion in the water. The front end will drop, and the tail will come up like that, and the marabou pulses up and down in a wave fashion. Proves absolutely deadly to trout.
Part-time analysis then, how are we doing?
Doing very well, Rob. Say it's your first time you've been out reservoir boat fishing, so I think it's been a great start. You've got a couple of fish in the first sort of half an hour that we started, and that's a great start, that is, isn't it? Most novice anglers to this discipline, they wouldn't do any better than that. So you've had a great start, you've had a couple of fish, a couple of pulls. I think your casting, obviously still working on that, so that's something we can improve upon.
That's polite.
No, but it's going well, it's going well. I know you think perhaps you're doing something wrong, but we can't catch a fish every cast. It's a matter of being out and enjoying it, and the anticipation of catching one is sometimes as good as the catching of them.
One of the challenges that I'm finding straight away is when I'm casting into or with the wind, not too much of a problem. But as soon as you go across it, that's making a bit of a difficult game
for me. A right-left wind can be very difficult, especially for a right-hander anyway, because it's blowing the line in towards you. Yeah, nothing much wrong there, except the discipline.
Let's concentrate a little bit more. Oh, well, it's all part of the fun, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Yeah, you do with trout fishing, you'll get hookups and drop-offs. Luckily, if there's a few about, you'll get another one, and that's what it's about.
Well,
so, oh, I've got one.
Hello. Hello, there we go.
Managed to snag one. Well, there we go. That proves that the method we've got is working.
See, I think they're shallower at the moment. We've got him. Lovely. Well, I've got to say that I have thoroughly enjoyed this. For a start, as a carp angler, it is completely different to what I normally do. And that's one of the great things, you know, within our sport, we tend to compartmentalise ourselves. We do what we do, so fly anglers fly fish and carp anglers carp fish. But just stretching the boundaries a little bit is really, really good fun. It doesn't matter what we fish for. We're all brothers of the angle, really, and I might be sort of waxing lyrical about this sort of thing, but just going outside the comfort zone and trying something different is really, really good. And look around us. Just look at the scenery. Look at the weather for a start. It always rains in Wales, does it? Just have a look at that. The scenery is as good as anywhere I've been in the world. And at the time that we've got now, where travel restrictions are on, etc., etc., you know, you can come here, you can do this, you can have a holiday, you can have your staycation, and actually you can try something very, very different to what you normally do and learn it. Or alternatively, if this is what you do, come out and enjoy it, because it is great, great fun. The company's been reasonable as well, obviously. I have to say that too. The lads are absolutely brilliant. They've been very, very patient with me. I think I've caught the bow rope and the boat and myself and the net and various other things, probably a little bit more than I've caught fish. But it has been immense fun. And you know what? I'm definitely going to come back.
Discover fishing in Wales.